We have three different cables and then two temporary rods that will help us to do the test.
One length of wire that is colored red, and that is our current cable. Then we also have one that is colored yellow, and that is for our potential cable. And then the green one is going to connect between the earth terminal on the meter to the rod under test. Okay, we also have these rods. These are temporal rods or auxiliary rods that we are going to use to carry out the test. Okay, so let's go. So first of all, I am extending this current cable. Extending this one far away. No, one of the chips. This is the end. So I plant the auxiliary rod and then clamp it. Okay. Then the same thing will happen with the potential cable also. So we plant it into the ground, and then clip it. Okay, so we have our current cable there, and then the potential cable there. And so now I'm back to the area of the earth rod under test. And this is what we are going to do. So this is the potential cable, and I will slot it into the slot that is marked P for potential. And then this red also goes to red, and that is the current cable. All right, so now this green is going to go between, this is the rod under test. So we plug each cable to the slot that is labeled E. Okay, so here E. Now what we have to do is that we tune this knob to the appropriate ohms value. So you have 20 ohm, you have 200 ohm, and then we have 2000 ohm. All right, so since we don't know the resistance value of the rod to the earth, first of all, let's regulate it to 2000 ohm. All right, so this is the test knob, and so you press for a few seconds, it will read, and then it ends there. Okay, so this, okay, so the reading here is between 20 ohm and then 19 ohm. All right, so actually we can bring it back to 200 ohm, then we test. So okay, so it's 20 ohm. So 20 ohm is not good enough, and so we have to find a means of improving the earthing for this particular wiring. Now we have several ways of doing that. One of the ways you can use to improve or reduce the resistance reading of the earth electrode is, one, you can decide to treat the soil with chemicals. Then secondly, you can also decide to elongate the earth rod. And then thirdly, you can also decide to bury more earth rods in parallel with the main rod. Okay, so in this very week, I have decided to use multiple rods in parallel. All right, so first of all, I'm going to bury another earth rod, and then I will connect a cable from the main rod to that second rod, and then we will see how that reduces the resistance of the main electrode. So let's test again. When we tested, we got 20 ohms. So I'm testing again, so we'll be sure of the value. Okay. All right, so this is the second rod I have buried. This is the second rod I have buried, and so actually I will change this cable. This is not the cable that I'm going to use for the final connection anyway. This is too small, but it's just for demonstration purposes. So I'll connect that to the main rod. So I'm connecting the supplementary one to the main one. Okay. So use the clip on it. All right. So now I have connected this rod to the other one there. And then I'll carry out the test again to see if there will be any reduction in the value we got earlier. Okay, so test. Okay, so now I have 12. I have 12.1 ohms. It means there has been a reduction of about 8 ohms. Okay, and so what I would do is that I'm not yet satisfied, so I'm going to get another rod and then erect the third rod in parallel with the main one. So I'll be having two other rods erected to supplement the main one. Okay, now if you don't want to do that, then you can get a very long rod to erect, or you can decide to get an earth treatment chemical to treat the soil around the rod.
I still have to improve the earthing system to be able to give me less than 10 ohms. Then I'll be satisfied. All right. And so I'm going to do another earth rod. And then at the end, I'll take my test to be sure that I have less than 10 ohms. All right, so at the end of the arrangement, after burying the other electrodes in parallel with the first one, this is the value I'm getting for the earth electrode resistance. It has now reduced drastically. From the first test we did was around 20 ohm. At the final arrangement, we have now gotten 6.4 ohms. For the earth electrode resistance. All right, so now that we are satisfied with our electrode to earth resistance value, we have to prepare an inspection chamber for the earthing system, what we normally refer to as the earth chamber for inspection. So this is my earth chamber, and this comes with a cover with a label indicating that this particular chamber is for earthing arrangement. And so that is the earth rod down there with the connections to it. All right, so thank you very much for watching. Please, if you have any questions, you can ask your questions in the comment section. And if you have not subscribed yet, kindly do so for more videos. Thank you.